Dr. Shamim. I would like to call SR Bago. Last but not the least, I would like to call Subhash Kumar sir, and the memento will be presented by Puneet Khanna sir.
Good afternoon, all B-Fire engineers.
Suddenly something came up that why not we synergize our effort to create a council.
Right now, you see at the national level, there's a vacuum in the national policy formulations as regards the fire engineering is concerned. I myself have been member of core committee of National Building Code. There I've seen that fire engineers, I was the only one over there. That gap has been filled by the MEP consultants with all regards to their competency. They don't have the kind of cutting edge knowledge, applied knowledge that we gather because of our unique identity of the course. It's the only course, as we all know, which encompasses the technology, the psychology, the very different ways. We are, no, undoubtedly, we are jack of all trades, and that is the need of the hour as far as this profession is concerned. So we had this concept of Council of Fire Engineers on the lines of Bar Council of India, on the lines of Architectural Council of India, so that it becomes a forum to fill in the vacuum, to fill in the gap that is there in the national level. All these codes and standards, they are being formulated, as I said, because of the MEP consultants and also because of all sort of stopgap arrangements. We could be an alternative to all this, a viable alternative for setting up our goals, education, and other, there's so many arena is full of it. So I would like to invite the legends, Dr. Mishra, Dr. Shamim, to please have a few words and set the ball in motion, please.
There's an architectural council, there's a pharmacy council, medical council, engineering has an act, there's national institutes have an act, but this fire related fraternity doesn't seem to be governed by everything. I would not be exceeding in my remarks. We are only a fire advisor. And I do not know whether we all are available to guide him properly to take decisions regarding fire engineering. I don't know. Regarding fire safety, fire and so on. How will you work if you are not able to give him the right inputs? So therefore, it's the utmost requirement now that we, since we are all here, to come to a consensus saying that either we should have an act which will help us to work properly. Like for example, there may be people who would like to go in for new colleges in fire engineering, unless there is something to control them, it's not possible. You see, I remember when myself and Dr. Shamim were very keen in the beginning to start this BE fire engineering, the drop box in the All India Council for Technical Education does not have fire engineering as a subject. It has safety and fire technology, in which most colleges treat them only as safety. Hardly, there may be a few who are in the technology of fire, with the result that there is no engineering aspect at all as far as these colleges are concerned. There's only one college, and that is the National Fire Service College, which takes the concept of engineering into the aspect. All graduates who pass from this institution are better placed as far as engineering aspect are concerned. Today, everybody must know what is engineering. Simply knowing safety has no value. And therefore, it is absolutely essential that we formulate in this two-day deliberation something which is related to an act which will take into account. A draft probably has been formulated already. Maybe it will be circulated to most of you. It's in your bag. It will tell you what we have thought in the process. It will be governed by that act. The act has also one advantage, that it will help you to promote autonomy in the long run. because in order to make it autonomous, there's only one single college, and to make it autonomous, it may not be very difficult. But we should think in those terms, because people can't dictate about fire engineering to you by those people who do not know what fire engineering is. That should be a very difficult job. So we have to put our foot down and tell them, look, these are the rules if you want. That's why we have a panel here. And I think the next person I would like is Dr. Mishra to come forward and enlighten us a little bit on this aspect. Yeah, we already remember we have a scheme formulated for autonomy, we have a scheme formulated for the Act, and we have a scheme also formulated for the Council. So this will decide whether people all over should have new colleges in fire engineering or whether they should emulate the practices that are followed here. Dr. Mishra.
Of course, it's to a serious issue that we intend debating upon. We have a journey of over 38 years by now. Yet we look forward to have the kind of recognition that we deserve. I have been raising this issue at several platforms and also in the Government of India as to how we proceed to get the recognition that is due for the fire engineering community in the country. We have heard Ms. Sana about her Everest summit, and the raising of NFSC is no less than an effort which is required to reach the level that we are looking forward to have. And even I have been meeting was stuck up. I had to make a request to Dr. Manmohan Singh, who was then Prime Minister of this country. I said, look, the contribution that has been made by the fire engineers or the fire engineering community and the fire service profession as a whole is enormous. And the only thing that we lack is a recognition, our own institute. And the institute, the objective was that I should get it established under the statute, or rather an act of the parliament. I met the HRD minister also and requested her that it was advised to me by Mrs. Smriti Irani that why don't we join the engineering community, why we intend having the fire engineering as a separate identity. And that appealed to me that if I have my own identity, either I should have those credentials before the country that they accept us, or else I should have some means, some provisions somewhere, so that we get, the day you graduate from the Nagpur University or any other university for that matter, then we have that status. Otherwise, what is happening today, though we have the Bachelor of Engineering degree with us, but is not taken at par with the other engineers in the government parlance. And then we all sat together, we discussed it, how do we move about it. Again, I approached the Ministry of Law, approached some member of parliaments, and I requested some of the MPs that look, the Architects Council got the statutory status by a private member bill moved by Pillu Modi, who was member of parliament that time. And this is my objective, that I should move in this case also as a private member bill in the parliament. And for that matter, we needed a draft for Council of Fire Engineers in the country. The second objective that I have in my mind is that everybody who is getting into this profession, other than the people who are from this profession, there has to be a check somewhere. Today, you have more number of fire engineers in the country than actually graduated from the Nagpur University or any other university. You talk to anybody who does the plumbing work, he is also a fire engineer. And when we get the resume, everybody claims to be a fire engineer, which I do not personally want. I think we should draw a line somewhere. Hey, look, this is enough. Now from hereafter, if you possess these qualifications and if you have registration with the Council of Fire Engineers India, then only you can be a fire engineer, and then you can practice as a fire engineer, you can be a consultant or anything. This is the first step that we have taken. We have prepared a draft. Dr. Natarajan has done enormous work on that. And this draft is, I think, on WhatsApp also. I request you all to kindly go through it. And if you have any suggestions to make, then perhaps we can incorporate those, take it to the Ministry of Law again, get their views on it, rather get it vetted from them, and then I move it to or pass it on to some member of parliament, and then we see that this becomes a law of the land. So with this objective we are moving, and I need support of each one of you in this direction. And if it is a concentrated effort by all of us, then perhaps we can win, and that win would be no less than an Everest summit. Thank you all very much. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. I do agree with you that we need to go in coordination with the Ministry of Law, Ministry of HRD, Ministry of Home Affairs, and see whether there can be some consensus to bring about a law which governs this proliferation of fire-related matters and so on. I would now like to request Mr. Vasudevan to come forward and elaborate on this aspect.
Good afternoon. First of all, it is my privilege to be on this dais with Dr. Shamim and Dr. Mishra, who has taught me the ABCD of fire engineering when I was in ninth batch. It is an honor, sir, to be sitting with you on the dais. In fact, it was a surprise when my name was called onto this dais. Thank you very much. I would also like to convey the wishes of about 60 odd fire engineers who are staying in Middle East. We have 38 engineers in Middle East. I am presently at Kuwait for last 15 years. The challenges we faced in the beginning in 2001, probably I will address it to the students in the evening. We had a struggle, and today we are 38 and we take decisions, and that is being enforced by the management of oil industries in Middle East. So we have reached that level. Due to the sheer perseverance of excelling, and I'm sure with this kind of people sitting on the dais, we can achieve more than that. Now coming to the topic, I don't think there is any better institution in this country which can develop a Fire Council Act than NFSC. Now I think there are some 2-3 colleges which have started producing fire and safety engineers, but we have a wealth of experience of about 35 years plus, and talking about 600 engineers, we are talking about more than about 1 lakh years or days of experience. Now coming to the issue, as Dr. Mishra rightly said, our fire engineering probably, I think he was mentioning about not getting that due respect in the country. Actually, I am a certified safety professional from Board of Certified Safety Professional USA. I am glad to tell you, our engineering is recognized by BSCP. When I sent the certificate to them, they recognized and sent it back to me that I can write the examination for Board of Certified Safety Professional. And I am surprised that it is not being done in India. When a US institution can recognize our degree, I am surprised that it is not being done in India. It's a news to me, sir. To be honest, it's a news to me. Then coming to the issue, what we can do. To be honest with you, Mishra ji, I have not gone through the Fire Council 7 or 8 pages, what was circulated on the WhatsApp. But definitely I can say we can do some small things. The most important thing what we have to do, what I find missing in the third world, is we need to create a public awareness on the fire safety issues in this country. This is very much lacking. You just go to any mall, you will see the fire exit being blocked. And then the firefighter is blamed for not rescuing a people. This is a basic thing which should be a law. If somebody blocks the fire hydrant, he has to be put behind the bars. As simple as that. So this is one public awareness campaign need to be done from our side as the, I say forefathers or the leaders of our group. I request you, because I live abroad, I may not be able to contribute that much, but I request you people to take up this cause. There should be a public awareness on fire safety issues. In fact, I would suggest that all over the world, these kind of alumni's make a lot of procedures and standards which are being adopted. I think there can be no better institution than NFSC to develop a fire safety audit checklist. A fire safety audit checklist should be made by NFSC, and it should be pushed in such a way that it becomes a standard for all the institutions in this country to follow. And I don't think there is better experience than these people on the table who can make that checklist. So this should be our next aim. As Dr. Shamim was mentioning, in fact, I was doing my project work under Dr. Shamim when I was in, I will just close it out, with him in a steel plant of on the steel industry. Still, he has got that passion. I remember he used to tell me something about automatic monitor. That day I did not understand. Still, he has the passion for R&D. I'm sure this is one area where we have to work. I think I'm running short. I'm taking a lot of time. I would like to lastly conclude that we need to review our existing laws and practices as experienced people now to look at what better can be done before we suggest some suggestion. We need to understand what is there today before we something suggest better. Thank you very much for giving me this opportunity. Thank you.
Anything at home. It starts, I think, no. At home itself is more important than going out. As you rightly mentioned also, in fact, we have been thinking on those lines for some time that there should be some audit. We should go to every house and audit what are the safety parameters as far as fire is concerned. With this young generation at the back, maybe we will be able to make a little headway in that direction. May I now request Mr. Speaker to come forward and say a few words.
Acknowledge the director, Dr. Shamim Saab, for inviting all of us here. It's a really privilege and very nostalgic moment to be here in the amongst the all BE fires, the fresh batch of BE fire which is going to come up, the first year and second year students especially. It reminds you your college days and brings back those old memories. So thank you very much. Regarding this Council of Fire Engineers, this thought was given to me by Mr. Subhash Kumar, and I thought this is a brilliant idea. When the professionals in other areas have the council of like architects was mentioned, why not the fire engineers? See, I work in oil and gas industry. Last 35 years I have spent in the oil and gas industry only, and I know, since it's a very highly hazardous industry, the consciousness about the fire prevention is very high. Same is the case with other industries like aviation or steel industry, so many other industries. And in GAIL, I am proud to say that we have 44 fire engineers from this college. Maybe this is the largest number at one organization. In between, when the college was not able to produce the fire engineers, we had to go to other institutions. But as somebody also already mentioned, the input